today, Chairman Sir, is the day of Chundur Day. In Andhra Pradesh state, there is a village called Chundur. In 1991, August 6, 13 Dalits were massacred over there in Chundur. After 27 years, till justice is not done to the victim's family of SCs. This is the situation in this country. So that's what I would like to, the government's decision to introduce this bill. Let me make it very clear, sir. It is out of compulsion. Compulsion is aware the unfortunate instances that led this government to introduce this amendment bill. Chairman, sir, March 20th, the judgment came. After the judgment, the Dalits and progressive sections of this country were shocked literally. That judgment issued guidelines to protect public servants and private individuals from arbitrary and immediate arrest under the Scheduled Castes and Scheduled Tribes Prevention of Atrocities Act 1989. Chairman, sir, as youngster of this country, particularly from Dalit community, literally I was also shocked over this judgment. What happened, sir, after that judgment? As my brother Ravinder said just now, the controversial judge has been given a gift position after the judgment, very retirement day, as rewarded as chairman of National Green Tribunal. I sincerely request this government, if you have any sympathy towards this SCST communities in this country, please remove that person immediately. I would like to know this from the Honorable Minister also. Chairman, sir, the order bans automatic arrest and registration of cases for alleged harassment of SCs and STs and dilutes the law which aims to protecting the marginalized communities against discrimination and atrocities. The highly controversial ruling of the Supreme Court on March 28th deeply hurt the feelings of SCs and STs in this country. Chairman, sir, I would like to tell you very clearly in this August House, if anyone says that this government is committed to the welfare of the SCSTs, this government is committed to the upliftment of the SCSTs in this country, it is a big joke.
Yes.
In spite of so much pressure, is still supporting the controversial judge by giving him a gift post as chairman of National Green Tribunal, Chairman, sir. Chairman, sir, our TRS party, the first political party in the country, responded to this judgment as unfortunate, and our Honorable Chief Minister Sri K. Chandrasekhar Rao, sir, urged the Prime Minister to repose the faith among the Dalits and tribals and assure them that. Speaker, sir, Chairman, sir, I would like to elaborate this issue from the 1928. In 1928, Chairman, sir, Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar highlighted the violence against depressed classes in his submission to the Simon Commission. After the independence, two main laws were brought into effect in order to implement the provisions of Article 17 and other related articles of the Indian Constitution aimed at preventing the unequal treatment, oppression, and with the objective of eradicating inherent discriminatory attitudes against the Scheduled Castes and Scheduled Tribes. The Untouchability Offences Act in 1995, this August House has passed that act. In 1976, Chairman, sir, it was renamed as the Protection of Civil Rights, PCR Act. Owing to the ineffectiveness of the Act, the Scheduled Castes and Scheduled Tribes Prevention of Atrocities Act came into existence in 1989. Chairman, sir, aajkal is desh mein ek fashion ho gaya. Reservations ke khilaf baat karna, SCST Atrocity Act ke khilaf baat karna, is desh mein ek fashion ho gaya. So I would like to tell you very clear to this August House and to the nation, why do we need reservations in this country? And why do we need SCST Prevention of Atrocities Act in this country? Chairman, sir, the father of Indian Constitution, please, sir, give some time. It's an important bill, sir. The father of Indian Constitution,
10 minutes for us.
The father of Indian Constitution, Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar, rightly said that the essence of democracy lies in its representative character. In a country like India, its plural societies, how do we address the issues of representation? Representativeness is the essence of democracy. It has to be present at all levels, political, bureaucratic and all levels of the governance process. And also in the higher judiciary process also, we don't have any reservations for SCSTs in the higher judiciary, but we have in lower judiciary. I request the government, if you have any sympathy, if you have anything to do for SCSTs, please give reservations in higher judiciary for SCSTs. So that is why we need reservations, Chairman sir. We have reservations and will continue to have reservations until every last Dalit and last tribal practically feels that he or she in a part of the Indian society with equality. When the very survival of Dalits or tribals is not safeguarded, how can they avail the fruits of and become equals in the Indian society for the SCSTs? That is where this act makes difference. That's why this act should be there also. I would like to give some figures. As per NCERB records, India has over 180 million Dalits.
Just conclude.
Just 2 minutes. India has over 18 million Dalits. 6 Dalits women are raped over day.
Yeah.
Over the last 10 years, 2007 to 2017, there has been a 66% growth in crime against Dalits. So that I would like to tell you, Chairman sir, after this Modi-led BJP government came into power in 2014 and before long-ruled Congress government, these two parties have miserably failed to the understanding of this country and to OBCs and minorities. The present Modi-led BJP government is doing nothing short of its previous government. It is simply following the footsteps of the Congress.
Not like
this. Please, sir. When Indira Gandhi was Prime Minister,
you have one more speaker.
No, sir. From our party, well, I'm speaking. Please give some time, sir. When Indira Gandhi was Prime Minister, then India became Indira India. After that, emergency India. In emergency period, what happened? We are all know that. I don't want to get into all those things, sir. What happened now, sir? What is happening now presently? All the time we hear Clean India, Green India, Skill India, Make in India. Finally, today it is Modi India. In Modi's India.